gonna call meeting to order. It's 12 o'clock. Let's do, Karen, can we pass out an agenda? There you go. Would you mind passing one back there, Mr. Erskine? Great. And one for Bob. Alright, so let's go around the table really quickly, do introductions, and we'll react ourselves right then.
Daniel Devon, J. Enterprise, Vice President.
Rob Mika, Board Chair.
Secretary, Secretary. Great. And any public comments or announcements before we dive in? Okay, so item number three on the agenda is our June 26th board meeting agenda. And this is what I'm talking about right now. So we have a ton of projects that are coming up online, which I'm gonna do. Okay, we'll probably get a record progress for it later. That's okay.
That's a happy job.
So yeah, and so this is what I wanna talk about. So we haven't decided on how to use our infrastructure and planning committee, I think, in the most effective way. What I would like to do is just set a policy that we hear development projects exclusively through the infrastructure and planning committee. I know, it's tough because we don't have a good turnout and you want the whole board to be there.
It's tough for me also because I want to see the project and I'm not on that committee.
You can come to those meetings.
Yeah, I'm not coming to
the league. Well, you can switch your, you don't have to come to district identity. You can come to your insurance room. Then you should come to all of them because more.
I'm being selfish. I know I'm being selfish.
The board meeting and the development services group or whatever that Josh put together.
The development values. Yeah. So that's a working, that's like an ad hoc working group, which I would love for your involvement in, our representation.
We have another one.
Yeah. We did, yeah. Oh, you got your own.
Yeah.
Great. So what is happening and why I think that it's important that we at least consider this idea is that our agendas are, you know, we meet every other month and we have enough going on in the districts that we could have presentations from developers at every single meeting. And we really only have enough space on the agenda, enough time to hear from two.
Yeah,
right?
I agree.
And it just gets too packed. So like looking even at what's on the docket for June, I did confirm with Tanner on the Morrison Hotel way back when, but I'm okay if we want to kind of change how we do things going forward, reaching out and saying, you're welcome to come to the infrastructure planning committee. But I think that frees up space on our board of directors meeting to have more meeting conversations. So.
I mean, I agree, four is too much. And.
Well, and the other thing I want to point out though is that if we have presentations, we only have enough room for presentations, two people, period. And normally those are eaten up by developers. And I would like for our board meetings to not just be presentations from developers. For instance, I'd like to have a conversation about policy and advocacy and what our role is in that. And as to jump, to help us have that conversation, I'd like to invite other organizations who are doing policy and advocacy work to come and do those presentations. So I'd like to have CA there, I'd like to invite the Chamber of Commerce, you know, of which we are members. We are not members of the ISFED, but a lot of other organizations like ours are. California Downtown Association is also does some work in the policy advocacy area. And so in order for us to, I mean, neither of our committees are really suited for those conversations. So I'd like to do that at a full board meeting. But I can't do those kinds of things if I'm constantly getting eaten up by developer meetings.
I agree. I agree. Maybe we can do a balance, maybe, one presentation from the developer and another type of presentation, a policy one, because, again, look at Morrison, David Gordon's project, these are multi-year projects, and it's not that we're taking positions on them anyway, so it's not going to be dead in at a certain time, just between submittal and their first hearing, which is maybe 2 to 3 years. If we do Times Square in November, doesn't make
So, Daniel, just so I understand, tabling the your personal involvement on the board and the fact that you like district and then the committee and want to stay on that, but also want to hear from developers. What are the downsides of not having developers present at infrastructure planning meetings?
I think it's a couple things. One is the full board doesn't get to see the project of coming up from the street, so maybe I'm just speaking, I just for myself, but maybe the committee members who are not part of infrastructure planning. Also, like you said, get a greater turnout of the actual board meeting and if you have the committee, maybe substantially less, I don't know the numbers to it. And so that allows the community, like if I'm a resident or a business owner, I'm probably only going to come to the board meetings, but I still want to see what's happening. So unless I have a specific interest in a specific project, I don't get that full exposure of everything that's happening in the district. But yeah, I'm one of four or five in the entire board. And personally, to be honest with you, I just use the proposal at CCA or other form of anyway.
Right, exactly.
So it's not the biggest deal for me personally, but I'm thinking also from the for the board members.
I feel like because we aren't taking a position, it should be maybe twice a year the chance to come present projects in the district.
So you bring up a good point, Channing, which is we don't take a position, and that's something that infrastructure planning, well, it's something that the development values group has been talking about. And I would like for them to make a recommendation to the full board about that, but that is definitely something worth considering.
Twice a year?
No, the fact that they don't take a position.
Yeah. In which case, we should have an extended board meeting as needed, you know, or you know, have two presentations per meeting and make sure that everybody's going to do time.
What about 2 hours? Four board meetings, 10 to 12.
I am for
this is like 30-30.
This is going to be a very long conversation, presentation.
This is not locked in. I'm put this together to show you all how I have to chisel away at agendas every time. We definitely can't make this happen. And even if we whittle it down to two presentations, by the way, this number 4 is not the developer. It's a new business that's coming to the district, which I think is actually kind of the one I want to mention.
Yeah, so I'd say it would be 10 and.
But then we can't do what I would like to do, which is have this conversation about policy and advocacy in Los Angeles. And maybe that's a separate meeting. We don't have to call that here a board meeting, but I would like to utilize those board meetings in a more strategic way. You know what I mean?
It feels to me, again, since we're not taking a position, and it's interesting to know about, that you could put these presentations at the end. Yeah, or come with a, you know, take early lunch, like you can attend the come see 11:30, you know.
That's interesting.
I thought about it overnight, and I think having a full board is important for presentations.
Yeah. I think it was 3 months. I think it's not bad to dedicate that a lot of time, but give people the chance to say, okay, great, I'll read about it in paper, like I go, or this is what I'm going to talk about in another board business, which is policy.
Is policy going to be a month of every board meeting?
No, no.
Smart, I guess, that we keep it locked.
What's that? Oh, yeah. And that's what's going to happen. Is that missed it?
Conversations are not something that I think we should need to do.
But we do more of that kind of thing.
If bid wants to, you know, I've been hearing that a bid, that from board members that we need to be more on, they want a bigger policy update, and there's potential for this group to get more involved. Whether it's writing letters, you know, in support or against of, you know, motions or getting more
Right.
I would like to have an opportunity to educate this group on what already is going on, what our membership with various organizations gets us. And therefore, we can then have a conversation about, well, what's our role in this broader landscape? By the way, we provide clean and safe services. So many of the, much of the work that is already happening is beyond the scope of the business group in the district. And there's probably few places for us to plug in where it aligns with our core mission and contract, right?
Well, most of our money does go to clean and safe. So
yeah.
All this policy advocacy is more effort.
Right.
Time. Not much dollars.
Absolutely, yeah.
So
I mean there's no decision to be made, I want to have a conversation about how you feel about this. I mean, Bob, just to kind of fill you in, we were talking earlier about given the fact that the board doesn't take positions on development, our agendas are often eaten up by presentations from developers, which I think is really important, and I have made a suggestion that we consider reallocating time on the infrastructure planning agendas to allow for developer presentations. These guys think, and I agree, I see the point, that because the full board doesn't attend infrastructure planning meetings, we're missing out on an opportunity to get the developers to come to the full board.
So the alternative is what?
The alternative is limiting every board meeting to two meetings only. Sorry, two presentations only. And in this case, like item number four is not a developer, but I would like to hear from them. So giving at least one, if not both, of the slots to developers. That just becomes challenging because sometimes I don't hear from people until it's like right on the line. Well, they're like, hey, you know, we need to get on your agenda before. You know,
right, so we can, we can reach out to them proactively too, because I'm sure someone has a list, and we can talk about this list of pending projects,
whoever
our communication director is, or whatever else, we can start reaching out proactively. Well, I think, sorry, one question to frame this for me is, what is the purpose of the presentation for that? Is it to educate the board, or is it to educate our stakeholders?
Which is why, I mean, it also gives, and this is a part of these conversations that are happening in the development values working group, where they're considering, do we start taking positions on projects? And part of my understanding and like feedback from people who've been here longer is that decision was made because there was conflict of interest potentially.
Mm-hmm.
And
do you remember what it was about?
Sure.
It's Gary, right?
Right.
Was it his project?
Well, it was one that he knew people. I think it was a mirror and he was trying to support me. I think he was trying to broker. I don't know, you know Gary better than me. Because this was 10 years ago.
Yeah.
And I think it was a quid pro quo. And that's when we decided that we were going to do it.
It's tricky because that's always going to be
right. Exactly.
Absolutely.
But if that just requires that the party in question removes their vote, you know.
I mean, but that's tricky because you can almost say most people will have a conflict almost every project. At least property owners, for example, you can argue will have a conflict on every project. The challenge is by not taking position, one or two things are ahead of the time, right? Someone from the bid will show up and speak at a hearing, not necessarily in general support of the type of the project, right? Isn't Josh or whoever it was.
Yeah.
doesn't go up and say, South Park supports the project. They say, this is consistent with our values of X, Y, and Z.
Right.
Right. But if no one shows up, what the developer most likely will do is, we reached out to the South Park.
Check that box.
Yes. And there's an assumption of support.
Yeah.
So you have to be mindful of that. Because not showing up is the same as not opposing.
Sure. I mean, in my opinion, I think that the group has more weight behind it than it's using. And
right.
we could be more influential in the way that our public space is being used if we take positions on things like this.
Well, public space isn't the private space. Public space, okay. Let's say it's the Lindsay Plaza or the Kiefer Triangle or whatever. I don't think we should take positions on that. But if it's like another developer's project, whichever one of these you want to pick from, there it becomes a little bit blurry. I don't know what the solution is. Like, you guys on this, right? You know the situation we've been having with one of our neighbors. Like, how do we get past that?
It's tough.
I'm with you that public space is different than private, but even if it comes down to traffic, egress, landscaping,
right.
where their public benefit dollars are going, like all of those things are. Affect the work that we do.
Absolutely. What are other bids doing on this topic?
What do other bids do?
Yeah.
It varies. Yeah.
It varies. So if a bid opposes a project, what's the impact of that?
Well, the council office sometimes takes that into consideration. I mean, I think it was different when the dynamic was that, when we started chairing a company, it was a little different. Frankly, I'm not sure. We don't have real teeth here, right?
It's just
a...
We're a member of the community. So let's say if it hits a ZA hearing, zoning administrator hearing, if someone goes up and says, we have concerns over X, Y, and Z, the zoning officer, the hearing officer, whatever, will say, I'm going to continue the hearing. I want to hear how you can respond to these concerns. So it gives you an opportunity in an important setting.
Yeah.
To voice concerns you have, and typically the DA officer will say, I want you to respond to this before I rule.
Right.
So let's say we go down the path and either opposed or support a project. What would be the methodology? What would be the process by which that would happen? Would they come first with the infrastructure and then make a presentation, and then the infrastructure will determine if it goes to the full board? Or
yeah, I think is if there are enough questions at the board meeting first, that they then follow up and maybe
I'll do it the other way around.
Yeah. Oh, just to dig into consider things and
say, yeah, no, I got you. Present the board. Can't dig deeper than community.
Yeah.
One thing I would also like to suggest we make as a requirement is that their talking points, their PowerPoint that they run through sometimes.
Yeah.
That we have the ability that they have to let us post those on the web page. So that what they are telling to the board gets out to any interested parties in the community.
Okay, I'm hesitant to post it on the website for a number of reasons. One, we just redesigned the website. Well, we're just trying to keep it like for information that is most frequently asked for. That's what I want to say.
How about the newsletter?
Sure,
the newsletter?
Yes, definitely.
And then we just give a link to.
Frankly, whoever asks for presentations, if we have ownership of the presentation, we have to share that.
I know, but I'm just saying we don't require the presenter
to
leave us a copy of their presentation, and they know that it's going to be distributed through either the web page or through the newsletter.
Sure. I mean, I don't have a problem making that requirement.
I mean, that way we're getting the word out to the community, right?
Yeah, that's great.
So, link it.
Okay.
Yeah. And then if they have to come back, well, we deal with that. Off the web page, off the newsletter, until the board has made a decision.
Sure. So, but I like Chaney that in a little bit, having it go to the full board, and then if there are, if the board
has issues.
If the board is ready to take a vote at that time, they can.
Yeah.
If they have issues and want the group to come back, then they can kick it to the infrastructure planning committee.
Or those issues will be addressed then.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, that's good.
Sure.
Can we put a hard timeline on these presentations?
We're trying.
Yeah, I say that they have 12 minutes with a couple minutes at the end for Q&A. I tried really, really hard to keep them on.
So what do you think about having a board meeting in, so you get enough time?
So that allows for two
yeah.
presenters and then staff presentations as well.
Plus your advocacy stuff.
Yeah. The fact that we meet every 2 months, I'm okay to spend that
yeah.
2 hours.
Yeah.
Versus if it was every month at 90 minutes.
Okay.
That's me personally, I don't know if you should put out to a board vote or not.
No,
I'm
it doesn't have to go.
I'm okay going for 2 hours. Yeah. I like yours.
Close is 12:25.
Oh, I like it.
Yeah.